confess, she is not punished. Narrated the following. Two disputants came to the Messenger of Allah. One of them said, judge between us according to the book of Allah. The other, the more intelligent one, said, certainly, O Messenger of Allah, judge between us according to the book of Allah and allow me to speak. The Prophet said, speak. He said, this son of mine was working for this man and committed zina with his wife. They told me that my son was to be stoned, so I ransomed him from them by paying them 100 sheep and a slave girl of mine. Then I asked the people of knowledge, and they informed me that my son was to be lashed 100 times and banished for a year, while the woman is to be stoned. The Messenger of Allah said, by the one in whose hand is my soul, I shall judge between you by the book of Allah. As for your sheep and slave girl, they are to be returned to you. He then had set his son lashed 100 times and banished for 1 year. He then told Unais al-Aslami to go to the other woman, and if she confesses, to stone her. She confessed and was stoned to death, affirming the act via witnesses. Allah says, and those who accuse chaste women and produce not four witnesses, flog them with 80 stripes and reject their testimony. Forever they indeed are the evildoers. If four free and respectable men witness that they actually saw a man entering his private part into that of a woman, then both the man and the woman are to receive the legal punishment. If three bear witness and the four refuses, then the three are to be given the punishment for slander, as the above verse demonstrates. Furthermore, when the issue concerning Abu Bakr occurred, and he mentioned the story and continued by saying, the witnesses were called forth. All bore witness. Then these three gave their testimony. The issue became very difficult for Umar. When Zayd came, he said to him, do not bear testimony. Allah willing accepted the truth. He stated, as for zina, I do not bear witness to that. However, I saw something very disgusting. Umar said, Allah is greatest. He gave the three the legal punishment, and he had them flogged after being punished. Abu Bakr said, I bear witness that he committed zina. Umar understood from this that he had repeated his calumny and that he should be punished again. Prevented him, saying, if you flog him, you should stone your companion. So Umar left him and did not flog him. Ruling concerning one who had intercourse with a close relative within the prohibited degrees of marriage. If someone commits zina with a relative that is within the prohibited degrees of marriage, he is to be killed regardless of whether he is a virgin or a non-virgin. If he marries the woman, he is to be killed and have his wealth taken from him. I met my maternal uncle, and with him was a banner. I said, where are you going? He replied, the Messenger of Allah sent me to a man who had married his father's wife. After his death, he sent me to strike his neck and take his wealth. Whoever commits animal bestiality. That the Messenger of Allah said, whoever commits a sodomy with an animal is to be killed, and the animal is to be killed as well. Punishment for homosexuality, sodomy. If a male commits sodomy with another male, the punishment is death. Whether they be virgins or non-virgins. That the Messenger of Allah said, for whoever you find doing the act of the people of Lot, kill the one doing the sodomy and the one being sodomized.